Now to remove the LCD panel from the digitizer and midboard, there are screws located around the LCD. These are also T5 screws that had to be removed. You can remove the display cable as shown here. You can see there's also some tape located around the LCD panel. You can remove this because this kind of adds some strength to the LCD being stuck to the midboard and digitizer. Then there's some more T5 screws located all around the LCD that holds the LCD into the midboard. Once all those screws are removed, you can take a flat tool such as this putty knife here and kind of slot it in between the LCD and the midboard to lift up on it. It is adhered around the edges, so you have to be careful to not bend the LCD too much or you can crack it. Once you work your way around the LCD panel with the flat tool here, you can see that it begins to give a little bit and you can pry on it carefully to remove it from the midboard. And we're still working with the flat tool here, removing the LCD panel. It is adhered quite well, and the hardest thing to do is to be careful and not break the LCD panel. That's something you do not want to do, so just take your time removing the LCD panel because it is adhered quite well around the edges. And now the LCDs begin to give a little bit more, and you can lift up on one complete side here to remove the LCD panel. Here we actually found another screw. There's a couple screws actually. Looks like it's just holding down tape, but it's actually holding down the LCD, so those have to be removed as well. And here we have the 9-inch LCD panel removed. Now after you remove the LCD panel, all you have left is the digitizer and the midboard.